How's it going, everyone? This is GWR Studios, and today we are going to be finding some more goofs in Thomas and Friends. Today's episode is Henry Special Cole. I hope you enjoy it. Alright, so at the beginning of the episode, we see Henry in the sheds. Henry is feeling ill, and he doesn't have the strength to go pull his train.
I suffer dreadfully, and no one cares.
And here's where I saw the first goof. Take a closer look at James's shed. The smoke isn't coming from James, it's coming off from the side.
Rubbish, Henry, snorted James.
James doesn't believe Henry. He thinks he's just being lazy. Later that day, Sir Topham Hatt came to see Henry.
What's wrong with you, Henry?
Sir Topham Hatt is concerned about Henry because he's been having so many problems.
If we can't make you better, we must get another engine instead of you to do the work.
This makes Henry very sad, but there's something kind of weird about this scene. Why is Sir Topham Hatt smiling? Doesn't he feel sorry for Henry? This has to be a goof. Later on, Henry goes to pull his first train, but Sir Topham Hatt is going to ride with him. Sir Topham Hatt was riding along so they could find out what was wrong with Henry.
Henry is a bad steamer.
The driver tells Sir Topham Hatt that Henry's fire can't produce enough heat. As a result, Henry loses steam and he has to take a rest. He finally comes to a stop at Edward's station.
Oh dear.
At this point, Henry thought he was done for.
I shall have to go away.
And here comes the next goof. When Henry goes into the siding, he runs into the station.
Go for the train.
And there's another goof. Right after Henry comes to a stop, he quickly moves forward. What's even more strange is that there's no chuffing sounds. Listen closely. But just when you thought it couldn't get any more weird, in the very next scene, Henry is in his original position. Sir Topham Hatt asks the fireman what he thinks is wrong. The fireman tells Sir Topham Hatt that the coal isn't right.
We've had a poor lot lately, and today it's worse.
But look at the fireman's left hand. If we take a closer look, we can see there's a piece of sticky tack. The fireman goes on to tell Sir Topham Hatt that the other engines have large fireboxes, but Henry has a small firebox. Because of this, Henry can't make enough heat. But if Henry were to use Welsh coal, he would run a lot better.
It's expensive, said Sir Topham Hatt, but Henry must have a fair chance.
When the Welsh coal finally arrived, Henry's driver and fireman were very excited.
Now we'll show them, Henry, old fellow.
The fireman carefully lit Henry's fire. They wanted Henry to steam as well as possible. But Henry was worried. He didn't think the coal would work.
You're spoiling my fire, complained Henry.
And here comes some more goofs. When the fireman talks back to Henry,
wait and see, said the fireman.
We can see sticky tack under his arm. And there's another goof in this scene. Look at Henry's tender. This section of it is blue. Does this mean that Henry used to be a blue engine? I'm blue, very strange.
We'll have a roaring fire just when we want it.
When Henry made it to the station, he felt great. He was steaming very well and was ready to pull the train.
How are you, Henry?
Beep, beep.
I feel fine.
Sir Topham Hatt asked if he was ready to go. His fireman replied that Henry was better than ever. But there's a goof in this scene that you might not have noticed. Moments ago, there was a troublesome truck in the background. But before Henry leaves, it turns into a van. And here's something else strange that I noticed. When Henry leaves the station, steam rises in between the coaches. And there's another goof. When Henry leaves the station, his brake coach is at the front of the train. But once he makes it to the open line, the brake coach is now at the back of the train. Henry feels great. He's never felt so great in his whole life. But there's more goofs. The brake coach has been flipped. Now, I don't think you guys are gonna believe the next goof I found. When Henry passes by, for a split second, we can see the opposite side of the coaches. Notice that they have a tannish color to them, and the upper portion doesn't have any white. Well, believe it or not, the studio that made the show didn't have the budget to buy a bunch of coaches, so in order to save money, they painted one side tan and the other side green and white. This explains why the coaches kept getting flipped. They always show the same side of the coaches because the other side has a different paint job. But in this one scene, they weren't able to hide it. Well, back with the story. As Henry continues to pull the train, he feels great.
Steady, old fellow, he would say. There's plenty of time.
Henry arrived at the station with time to spare, and Thomas just so happened to be at the same station.
Where have you been, lazy bones? Asked Henry.
But before Thomas could answer, Henry decided to leave.
Goodbye. Woo!
Thomas was shocked that Henry had so much energy, but look at his left eye. It's pretty clear that they didn't put his face on the whole way. There's a big gap between the eye and the face, and therefore, it is a goof.
Have you ever seen anything like it? Both Annie and Clarabelle agreed that they never had.
And this marks the end of the episode. Alright you guys, so those were all the goofs that I found in Henry's special Cole. This episode had quite a bit of goofs in it, but I've seen much worse in the past. Now as always, if you saw a goof that I didn't point out, leave a comment below and let me know. Thanks for watching, and have a great day.